and in this video we are going to do the basic rules of English narration, which is an elementary part of English grammar. So what is a narration? Narration is actually saying something a person has said already in two ways. We have two ways of representing the narration or the actual sentence a person has said already. We can directly tell what the person has said or indirectly. For example, Ram said, commas, inverted commas, he is fine. So we have represented whatever Ram has said in the actual form. If I write it as Ram said that he is fine, in this case I have not used commas, inverted commas here. I'm just representing whatever Ram has said in an indirect form. So today we are going to do the basic rules of narration or changing a sentence from direct to indirect. A direct speech has two parts. First, reporting verb. And then reporting speech. Like here, she said, my brother is a banker. So this part of the sentence is called reporting verb and this part of the sentence is called reporting speech. Now we are going to do the rules. First, we have to keep in mind how to change the tense of reported speech according to the tense of reported verb. For example, if the reported speech, reported verb is in present or future tense. Then we don't change the rules of, we don't change the tense of reported speech. For example, Ram says, I was very busy. Here we can see that this part of the sentence is in present tense, or the reported verb is in present tense and reported speech is in past tense. But if we change it into indirect form, the tense of reported speech will not be changed. Ram says that he was very busy. Clear? The second rule . If the reported verb is in past tense. Then we change the tense of reported speech as follows. Present indefinite tense. Changes into past indefinite, present continuous, changes into past continuous, present perfect, changes into past perfect, present perfect continuous, changes into past perfect continuous. And this is for present tense. If the reported speech is in past tense, then we change it as past indefinite, changes into past perfect, past continuous, changes into past perfect continuous. If the sentence contains or the reported speech contains shall, it changes into should. Will changes into would. May changes into might. And so on. Clear? Now the next rule, very important, because sometimes in your bank exams you get these kind of sentences or in which the reported speech is in universal truth, biological or geographical facts, quotes of some famous authors, authors or poets, then the tense of these kind of sentences remain unchanged. For example, the teacher said Earth revolves around the sun. This part of sentence is a universal truth. So if we change the it into indirect, the tense will not be changed. The teacher said that Earth revolves around the sun. Clear? Here, this part of the sentence is in past and this is in present. But because this part of the sentence is a universal truth, we are not going to change the tense of this. Then some words like here, this, ago, hence, today, tomorrow, yesterday, and last night, change as here changes into there, this into that, ago changes into before, hence changes into thence, today, that day, or the same day. Tomorrow changes into the following day. Yesterday changes into the previous day. And last night changes into the previous night. Clear? You must keep these things in your mind while changing a direct speech into indirect speech. Now come to the persons. We know we have three kind of persons in English language: first person, second person, and third person. Let's revise these persons or the type of pronouns we use in narration and how to change it into direct from indirect. First we have first person. Second person. And the third person. First person refers to the person who is talking, like I, we, us, our, my, mine, etc. The second person refers to the person we are talking to, like you, yours, etc. And the third person refers to the person we are talking about, he, she, and it. First person, the person who is talking. Second person, the person who we are talking to. And the third person, the person we are talking about. Now, how to change it into indirect? If we have these kind of words in the indirect speech or reporting speech, how will we change it? First person pronoun in reporting speech is changed according to the subject of reporting verb. We have to identify the subject of reporting verb to change the first person pronouns of reporting speech. Reported verb. Then second person pronoun is changed according to the object of the reported verb. the third person pronoun remains unchanged. We don't change. So whenever you are changing a sentence from direct to indirect, you have to change the first person pronoun according to the subject of the reported verb, second person pronoun according to the object of reporting verb, and the third person pronoun does not change. Now these rules were followed. Whatever we have learned so far are applied to assertive sentences.